मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू हरलीन मैम्स क्लास. एंड यस, यू ऑल आर सो लव्ड. एंड वेरी सून वी आर गोना बी बैक इन स्कूल. हेलो, आई एम बैक. एंडी, योर गुड ओल्ड एंडी. सो एवरीवन गेट रेडी विद इमेजेस. ग्रेड 3, रिकी टिकी. Good morning, children. Welcome to Harleen Ma'am's class. Today we're going to do chapter 2, Ricky Tikki Tavi Goes Exploring. It's a beautiful short chapter by Rudyard Kipling. It's taken from his book, The Jungle Book. You'll be doing that in grade 6 as well. So meanwhile, children, page number 6, Ricky Tikki Tavi Goes Exploring. Now, tell us about a pet, or about the one you would like to have if you don't have a pet. Which one would you want and why? I'm sure most of you have got dogs and cats, right? I have a pet snake. I'll show you in school one day. I'm just joking. All right. What are the most common pets that people usually have? Can you make a list of them? I think it's dogs and cats. Now, if you had an unusual pet, how would you look after it? You have to describe and draw it in your literature notebooks. That is unusual pet, not something which is the same mundane, usual pet we are talking about. All right, everybody, finger reading. This is a story of a mongoose. A mongoose is a Nevla mongoose called Ricky Tikki Tavi, that has just started living in a house with a young boy called Teddy and his parents. Ricky Tikki Tavi looked down between Teddy's collar and neck and sniffed at the boy's ear. Then he climbed down to the floor where he sat rubbing his nose. Now Ricky Tikki is a mongoose. He goes on to Teddy's collar and the neck and he's sniffing, smelling. And then he goes to the floor, obviously he's a mongoose, and he starts rubbing his own nose. Everyone rub your nose and show me. All right. Now, good gracious, said Teddy's mother. And that's a wild animal. I suppose he's so tame because we have been kind to him. Now, children, Teddy's mother comes in and she says, God, good gracious. You know, it's an expression of saying that, oh my God, you know. And that's a wild animal, she says. I suppose he's so tame. Tame, domesticated, opposite is wild. Because we have been so kind to him. You know, when you make a wild animal your pet and you look after and domesticate, train and tame him, he's no longer a wild animal. All mongooses are like that, said the big man who was a husband. If Teddy doesn't pick him up by the tail, or try to put him in a cage, he will run in and out of the house all day long. Let's give him something to eat. So the father, Teddy's father, says all mongoose are the same. And Teddy picks him up by the tail and he tries to put him in a cage if he will run in and out of the house all day long. So he knows that he has to be tamed. They gave him a little piece of raw meat. Raw meat which is not cooked. Yes, animals eat raw food. We don't. We only have raw vegetables and fruit, right? And a few vegetables. And Ricky Tikki really loved what? The piece of raw meat. When it was finished, he went out into the veranda and sat in the sunshine. Veranda is an open area. We all know it's veranda. He fluffed up his fur to make it dry to the roots. You know how animals do this? Yes, they fluff up, fluff, fluff, fluff. Then he felt better. There are lots of things to explore in this house, he said to himself. You know, you get a pet, you get a dog also, or a cat, they're going to be sniffing around in the house, they want to see what all is there, they want to explore, they're inquisitive, they want to see. I shall certainly stay, certainly, definitely stay here and look around what's there in the house. He spent all day roaming around in the house. Roaming about, walking everywhere, aimlessly really, just lolling around. he nearly drowned himself in the bathtubs. Some bathrooms have bathtubs. So what happened? Who was he? The mongoose, Rikki Tikki. He nearly almost drowned himself in the bathtub. He put his nose into the ink bottle on a writing table. There was an ink bottle. He's inquisitive. He's looking around. He's exploring. And he puts his nose into it. He climbed up onto the big man's lap to see how writing was done. You know, the father must be writing. And what does the mongoose do? He comes and sits on his lap and burnt his nose on the end of the big man's cigar. The big man is having a cigar. Not nice, not a nice thing to smoke. But what happens? He climbs up and he burns his nose. At nightfall, that is at night, he ran into Teddy's nursery to watch how kerosene lamps were lit. Now, the nursery here is a room for children, and Teddy is a small young boy. It's like a toy room. He goes there and he sees how lamps. Children, we have electricity, but earlier we did not have electricity, so we used to have lanterns and the kerosene, and you light it up. Yes, that's how we used to light up our homes. When Teddy went to bed, Rikki Tikki climbed into his bed. But he was a restless companion. Restless, always up to something, you know, unable to stay at one place, running around here, running around there, like all pets do. He got up with every noise and went off to find out who made it. Teddy's mother and father came in to look at their son Teddy, and Rikki Tikki was awake on the pillow. They were checking whether Teddy is sleeping, and Rikki Tikki the mongoose is wide awake. "I don't like that," said Teddy's mother. "He may bite my child, you know," she says. "I don't like it. I'm scared he might bite my little boy." "He will do no such thing," said the father. "Teddy is safer with that little beast." Who is this beast? Mongoose. "Than he had with a bloodhound to watch him." What's a bloodhound here? Hounds are kind of hunting dogs, children. So father is very convinced that mongoose is a better pet to keep than a hunting dog. If a snake came into the nursery, so he says, well, if a snake came into the nursery, but who's going to save Teddy? The mongoose. Mongoose is, yes, they can actually kill a snake. But Teddy's mother wouldn't think of anything so awful. Awful, terrible, very bad. Obviously, mamas never think of anything bad for their children. But it's hypothetically speaking, just thinking and saying it. She just hoped that the mongoose wouldn't bring any harm to her loving child, that's Teddy. I hope you all enjoyed the story as much as I did. Yes, we have the question answers. "I don't like that." Who says this? What is it meant by that? Why doesn't the speaker like it? "I don't like that." Think and answer. "He will do no such thing." You remember? Teddy's father said that. "Teddy is safer with this little beast than he would have been with a bloodhound to watch him." Who says this? Teddy's father. And why is Teddy so safe with the little beast? In case a snake comes in, the mongoose will take care of that. And yes, what is the danger? The danger is this. So the mongoose in the story, Rikki Tikki, is curious, inquisitive about everything. And that sometimes gets him in trouble. Do you think it is good to be curious? I think it's good to be curious to some extent, but not to the extent where there are do's and don'ts by your parents and other adults. Curious for questions, yes, science, of course, English, whatever. Ask questions. I'm curious to know that why does this happen? It's very important. But only till your limits, till your parents don't put the don'ts in it. Teddy's father is confident about having Rikki Tikki in the house, while his mother is a little scared. All mothers are, right? That the wild animal is going to hurt Teddy. How do you decide whether or not something is good or bad for you? What are the things that you consider while making such a decision? Well, what are the things that is for you to decide and note down in your notebook? I hope you all enjoyed the mongoose as a pet in Teddy's house. Yes. Thank you, children. Have a lovely day. And don't forget, you all are so loved. Bye-bye for now.